If you remember, during the time of Moses, people were complaining, and even though God has provided all their needs, God sent forth bread, water, and also during the nighttime, God sent forth fire to keep them warm. And also, God blessed them in every way, but yet the people are keep on complaining. And God has decided that He will send forth fiery serpents. And those people who were complaining, they were bitten. And what the Bible said, almost 1,000 people died every day. And Moses was pleading. He was asking God to forgive the people because the people will be consumed with the fury of God. And because of this, God instructed Moses that He will make a brazen serpent and put it on the pole. And God said that whosoever who are bitten by the fiery snake, they will live as long as they will look on the fiery serpent or a brazen serpent made by Moses. So it happens that many people who are bitten and who are still alive, the only way that they will be get healed is that they will open their eyes and look on the brazen serpent for them to live. And it so happened that when Moses did it, many people who were bitten by the serpents, they were alive, they were healed, and they were forgiven. And it is a type of Jesus Christ. Bible said as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so shall be the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believeth on Him should not perish, but have an everlasting life. It means to say that for all people to be saved, they just have to look on Jesus Christ hung on Calvary, because Jesus Christ paid the redemption of the people, that whosoever people today who are suffering from sin, who are suffering from the venom of sins, who are suffering from the serpent, the old serpent, the only way to be saved is to look on Jesus Christ. He was nailed on the cross. He was not. He was nailed on the Calvary. And the only way to be saved is very simple. Look on Him, and you will be alive, and you can have everlasting life. So thank you so much, and God bless.
The commandment is very simple. Talk to the rock. But you smote it, and the Bible said in the New Testament that rock was Jesus Christ. The rock that followed Moses in the wilderness was Jesus Christ. But because of his anger, because of his temper, he was thinking that he was only beating a literal rock, but actually he was hitting Christ. So once we are angry, we should be careful. We might be hitting Christ we don't know it, but that's why we should be careful with our temper. Because Moses, though God promised him to lead the people, but just a simple disobedience of a simple plan of God, Moses has forfeited the privileges which God has given to him. But one thing more, even though Moses was not able to cross the Jordan River, God has given him a very special attention, because God buried the dead body of Moses. Praise God. The body of Moses. So it means to say that God still acknowledged the good thing that Moses has done. Because no one in the Bible you will find that God buried their dead body. Only Moses buried only God buried the dead body of Moses. What a privilege. Thank you.